Today we will discuss about the similarity index. So how basically one can define the similarity index, what should be the criteria, what should be the individual contribution into the similarity index of the sources that a software basically counts. So how basically a similarity index one can judge or identify. So in this section I will discuss you can say I will focus on these points. What should be the acceptable limit of the similarity index? What should be the individual source and overall contribution in percentage? And then after number and nature of sources, these are the some points that I will discuss. So I have taken one example here, and in this example you can see the abstract situation that how basically author is writing. So what they are doing, basically they are just copying and pasting the content, and here you can see the 11th number, this gray one, right, from this source, and 12, 13 basically this one, and here at this one purple, ye coming from the two number, this one. So here you can see that the main contribution in this article coming from the second number resource for them, and its contribution individually is 18%, while in the other cases you can see here at 11 number and this 12, 13, the contribution is almost 1%. So this is just an example, and in the next point, in conclusion, you can see the contribution of each source. So here in this particular source you can see at 9, all these paragraph basically lines are taken from the source 9. Here this line taken from the source 14, and again this is taken from the source number 2. So what the point basically I want to share with you related to it. So you can see here this particular source which is mentioned by the software. So in general I use turn it into find out the similarity index and the plagiarism, but here what is more important for me, in general I don't a faith on the software, all these things. It is very clear here that source basically indicating clearly, but in general when the software suggest or highlight some words into the paragraph or into the line, into the sentence, then I check that particular thing manually, right? This is the point. But what basically I want to conclude from here. So if you see this summary report, in this summary report you can observe that overall similarity index here is 95%, and you can imagine the next point is about to the sources. So primary sources from there are all these content taken. So at number 1, this is 28%, mgmu.acn from here 18%, and this is DRI drishtias.com or drstias.com. The contribution is 14%. So what basically all these things indicate? Here the one of the important point that I want to mention here, the software basically doesn't define the exact source. They just predict that one kind of basically idea is taken from this particular source. It is not always true that the source basically will be relevant to that one or exactly the same. From there the idea or the concept or the text is taken. So here at number 1 you can see that is the website, at number 2 again website, At number 3, again website, and eight source indicating South Ganga MHRD website, and every at 11 number you can see the article basically was submitted into the NIT, submitted to the Chandigarh University, like that. So there are many things basically that you can see. So in this particular analysis, there is no direct indication that the content or the text is taken from a research article. The software Turnitin basically indicate that this is the most probable source from there the article text is taken, right? So this is the point, and now the point, next point, what should be the limit of the individual source? In general, people says that it should be 3% or less than 3% from each source, but it depends on the length of the paper also. If there are that is the review article, then in that case one can imagine the percentage of 3% from each individual source. So in general, we have to consider 1 to 2%. 2% is enough, I think, if one is taking the idea from a research article and that contribution indicating 2%, at the first stage it should be basically less than 1 or 1%. But if you are writing a review article or in general in introduction, some people basically highlight the idea or use the text, in that case 2% I think is fine from the individual source. And overall similarity index, when we talk about to it, it should be actually less than 10%. But where it should be less than 10%? In abstract and in conclusion, it should be zero. There will be no any similarity index or anything should be there copying from anywhere. Because when you are writing the conclusion, that is your related to your own work only, and you tell the reader about to the future perspective of your research work. So there is no possibility to come the similarity content or similar content into the conclusion. So conclusion should remain free from the similar content or similarity index, right? And the first and the next point is about to the abstract. And similarly, abstract, because you had planned about to a specific research problem, you know the research methodology or the experimental technique of that, how basically you are collecting the data and then analysis of that research work and outcome of it in terms of the future perspective and into the present, or if you had compared anywhere with your calculation and experimental observation. So there is no any chance that a similar content will come into the abstract and into the conclusion. So both the parts should remain free from the similarity index. Now point comes about to the introduction. Obviously, when you put the foundation of your research work, then you will consider a similar article, right? How basically your research work is progress, right? And how basically who are the top authors or the authors, those who basically work into that particular segment. So you will write in a systematic way in the introduction. So there is a possibility that 10% or 15% similarity index basically can come, because when we write any article, and you are also aware about to it, that no individual can generate the discipline keywords, right? So every researcher have to use those similar keywords. So it is a chance that the idea, the sentence becomes similar. But one should be very clear that they have to write everything, whether they are writing the abstract or introduction or conclusion, anything into the article of the body, they have to write in their own language. They can basically learn from the different research articles, but when they summarize or when they are putting foundation of the research article at that time, they have to write their own language. And here, this point is very important, because the way I communicate, the way I write something, scientific article or in general, that way is basically unique. So every person have their own unique quality, whether that is for the communication or for writing. So when you are writing anything related to your article, please write in your own language. Don't follow the sentences or keyword or text of any other article. But if you are taking an idea from any research article, then it is must that you should basically give the credit to that idea. So this is the important point into the plagiarism. So if you are writing without giving the credit and that idea is available already, so that thing basically is as per the ethics, right? You should give the credit to the person, those who basically bring the idea, bring the information. So it's your moral duty actually to give the credit to the original source, right? So this is the point, and with it actually I want to highlight one more thing. Here you can see this abstract, what the people actually are doing nowadays. The people thinks that they are smart, but they don't know how the technology basically is working. So here in this particular article, if you see the abstract says that we have achieved a simple empirical formula for incoherent scattering. And now the next one. So what the people are doing now, in our case, I have observed that a similar article has been published already in a reputed journal, as you have seen in this earlier slide. But right now, when they basically sent the same article to us, but what is the difference into the title, and they are using a different not almost all the different things, but they are using a different system. And how basically they are manipulating the data and the text, you can see from here. And they are writing here less than plus minus 5%, and into the earlier slide you can see here present formula is less than plus minus 3%, and present formula is less than plus minus 5%. So this was the article which was submitted in our journal, and when we had observed the similarity index, I found that similar article has been published already. So please avoid this kind of activity, that if you had already published an idea or a problem, you don't need to publish it again anywhere, whether the journal is in a different country or local or whatever the type of the journal. Please avoid this kind of activity, avoid the similar calculation or similar content to publish anywhere. So it will basically it can lose your reputation, it can lose your job, and there are many things basically which is related to the, and we have to take care it very seriously, because this is a problem, right? And this is a moral problem, and you have to see. So here in this particular slide you can see that is taken from the Zhang paper. So avoid they clearly mention that at what stage basically the similarity index exists. So they reject the article, and at what limit basically they accept, and at what the percentage basically of the similarity index they ask to the author to revise the article before accepting or before for the peer review process. So OSI stands for the overall similarity index. SMSI, single match similarity index. So here you can see This journal basically, the author, editor of that journal, says that they reject if overall similarity index is greater than 40% and if single match similarity index is greater than 10%. So you can take idea from here, and they accept the article for peer review process if overall similarity index is less than or equal to 25%. But and similar on the other hand, for the single match similarity index is less than 3%. So this is the criteria, and it can vary basically from one journal to the other, but in general this is standard. And in India, as per the UGC rule, that the overall similarity index should be less than 10%, and it should be pre-prom into the abstract and into the conclusion especially. So these are the problem, and these are the things that I want to share with you all. So if you have any question, you can ask or anything related to it. So thank you for watching this video and being with me, and I am sure that this kind of information will be and remain always helpful to you. So thank you, and thanks once again.